Hi all, today we can see a topic under relativity, that is Galilean transformation equations. In 1905, at the age of 26, Albert Einstein published two research papers dealt with this special theory of relativity. Also, he was published one paper regarding the explanation of photoelectric effect, and for that explanation he got Nobel Prize in 1921. The theory of relativity leads to many conclusions like contraction in the length of the object, dilation in time, and mass variations. These were beyond the sense of the common people during that time, because these effects are coming to importance when the bodies are moving at a very high speed, and that is comparable to the speed of the light. But in our daily life, we are dealing with the motion that is having speed very much less than that of the speed of the light. So to understand this special theory of relativity, first we can go to the frame of reference. Because in this relativity theory, everything we are explaining based on the relative motion. For that, we require frame of reference. We can classify the frame of reference into two types, inertial and non-inertial frame of reference. Inertial frame of reference means a frame of reference in which Newton's law of inertia is valid there. What is Newton's law of inertia? That is Newton's first law. Every body continues in a state of rest or of uniform motion unless an unbalanced external force is acting on it. That is, if the body is at rest or at uniform motion, it continues in that state. During that time, no external force is acting on that. If there is no external force is acting on that, that means no acceleration is there. So this type of frame of reference is at rest or it moves with a constant velocity. That means if the body is at a constant velocity, there will be no acceleration. So we can call this inertial frame of reference as an accelerated frame of reference. Whereas in the case of non-inertial frame of reference, Newton's law of inertia is not valid. That is, Newton's first law is not held good in the non-inertial frame of reference. That means it is not moving with a constant velocity. If the velocity is not constant, there will be an acceleration. So we can call non-inertial frame of reference as accelerated frame of reference. That is, some external forces there. So inertial frame of reference are an accelerated frame of reference, and non-inertial frame of reference are accelerated frame of reference. For example, when the bus is moving with a constant velocity, it is an inertial frame of reference. Whereas when the bus stops suddenly, it is a non-inertial frame of reference. So a starting bus, a stopping bus, all these are non-inertial frame of reference. The frame of reference concept is very important in the study of relative motion. When I am standing here, as per this room, that is, if this room I am taking as the frame of reference, I am at rest. But if a person is looking at me from other planet, then that planet is the frame of reference, and I am in motion with the same speed as that of the Earth. Now we can see the postulates of special theory of relativity. There are two postulates. The first one is the postulate of relativity. According to the postulate of relativity, all the laws of physics are same in all inertial frame of reference. In all inertial frame of reference, whatever the laws we are considering, that will not vary. It has the same form. The second one is about the speed of light, postulate of speed of light. This states that the speed of light in vacuum is constant in all inertial frame of reference, irrespective of the motion of the source or observer. What is the speed of light in vacuum? That is c, that is equal to 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second. It will be constant in all inertial frame of reference. In our daily life, when we are dealing with the relative motion, if I am moving in a car with a velocity of 60 km per hour and another car is moving in the opposite direction with 30 km per hour, then what will be the relative speed? Then we are adding it as 60 plus 30, that is equal to 90 km per hour. But it is not in the case of the speed that is that comparable with the speed of the light. For example, if I am moving in the spaceship with a speed of 0.6c, that is 60% of the speed of the light, and another person is coming in the spaceship in opposite direction with a speed of 0.7c, that is 70% c, then what is the relative speed there? Can we add that? No. That is the speed of the light c, that is equal to 3 into 10 raised to 8 meter per second, is constant always, that is invariant, that is known as the postulate of speed of light. The speed of light in vacuum is invariant in all inertial frame of reference, and it is independent of the motion of the observer or source. Galilean transformation equations. The transformations from one inertial frame of reference to another inertial frame of reference is called a Galilean transformation equations. Here we can consider two frame of reference, S and S dash. S frame of reference is at rest and S dash frame of reference is moving with a constant velocity v in the positive x direction. Let O and O dash be the origin of these two frame of reference. The coordinate axis of this S frame of reference are X, Y, Z, and that of S dash is X dash, Y dash, Z dash. For simplicity, here we are taking two assumptions. First one is that the origins O and O dash coincide at t equal to 0. That means initially both these frame of reference are coincide with each other. Then S is at rest, after that S dash is moving in the positive x direction with a velocity v. The second assumption is that the coordinate axis of the S dash frame and the S frame are parallel. That is, x coordinate axis is parallel to x dash, y axis is parallel to y dash axis, and z axis is parallel to z dash axis. Then after some time t, we are observing an event p in the s dash frame of reference. Let there be an observer in the s frame of reference and an observer in the S dash frame of reference. Both are observing this event. A physical event means something that like a collision of two particles or sudden lighting of a bulb, etc. Here the event P take measured by an observer in the S frame of reference, that we can denote by the coordinates X, Y, Z, T. And the same event measured by an observer in the S dash frame of reference, that can be denoted as X dash, Y dash, Z dash, T dash. Here X, Y, Z are space coordinates and T is the time coordinate. So the space and time coordinates of this physical event P is observed by the observer in the S and S dash frame of reference. Now, how these space and time coordinates are related with each other? Initially, the O and O dash coincide at t equal to 0. After that, this S dash frame of reference is moving along the positive x direction. Here, we are not considering the motion along the y or z axis. Only we are considering the motion in the positive x direction. So after a time t, when this event takes place, the coordinates measured by this observer in the S frame of reference is x. So x will be this distance. Then what will be this distance observed by the observer in the S dash frame of reference? That is x dash. Now how this x dash and x coordinates are related? Here this x dash coordinate and x coordinate are differing by this distance. What is that distance? Here, since this S dash frame of reference is moving with a velocity v, this distance will be velocity into time, that is vt. So we can write as this x dash and x differ by the distance vt. So x dash is equal to x minus vt. Now, is there any relative motion with respect to y and z axis? This y and y dash are parallel, z and z dash are parallel, but there is no relative motion with respect to y and z axis. So we can write this y dash is equal to y and z dash is equal to z. And this physical event is observed by the observers in S and S dash at the same time. So here T dash is also equal to T. So these transformation equations are known as Galilean transformation equations. So if we know the X, Y, Z, T coordinates, we can write the X dash, Y dash, Z dash, T dash coordinates using this Galilean transformation equations. Also, if we know the x dash, y dash, z dash, t dash coordinates, we can write the x, y, z, t coordinates also. That is, y is equal to y dash, z equal to z dash, t equal to t dash. Here, this x is x dash plus vt. So, these equations are called Galilean transformations